the blues.
Hello, my name is Luke, also known as Sam HD, or Curry Murray HD, if you want to be particular. And welcome to Two Stepping in Bristol, a documentary about dance in Bristol. So I've been filming dance in Bristol since February 2019, and since then it's been really good. So I thought I wanted to make this documentary to show people what it's all about. I'm indeed speaking to you live during lockdown. This is the editing desk where all the dance videos get brought to life. So bearing that in mind, a lot of the people who talked in this documentary were plugging their dance lessons and things, and obviously those are all cancelled at the moment. But if you like anything that you see, they are all offering video lessons for you to join. So let's start with the name, Two Stepping in Bristol. It actually comes from a caption to a dance video I saw by Bristol dancer Charles. Me and Charles, we've actually worked on a few things together. I always enjoy the passion and style he brings to the table, which actually leads me on to my first interview, which is with the man who introduced me to Charles and many other dancers, and that is David, also known as The Mixed Vibes.
If you just want to let them know who you are and all that stuff.
All right, guys, so my name is David Van Eker. I'm 21 years old. I go by the name of The Mixed Vibes, and I've been dancing for about 5 years now. My style is hip-hop.
I met David back in February 2019 at my local park where we filmed our first video together. I found out about him through a rapper called Young Huss, who I've collabed with many times beforehand, and who also took these pictures on the day. This was the start of my dance videography journey and the beginning of a massive catalogue of videos between us.
How hard has it been for you to like get your name out there within the Bristol dance scene, and like what type of ways do you normally do that even?
Well, it's been pretty hard, to be honest, because a lot of the dancers in Bristol are, well, they're not really dancers, you know. They're kind of people who aren't really living the life. They're just maybe doing it here and there and doing it with uni on the side. Like, it's been quite hard to find the community and, you know, build it like that. It'll be more interesting if I was in a city like London or even in the US, where there's a lot more going on and there's a proper industry for it. In Bristol, there's not many people who are really doing this and are really about this life and is really genuinely passionate about it. So yeah, I would say it's been pretty hard for me to make a name for myself, which is the truth, really.
Why would it be easier in somewhere like London and America compared to Bristol?
Simply because there's a lot more events going on in these cities. There's always things being held because there's a lot more people it's more populated in these cities. So there's just a lot of opportunity.
So we're just doing an interview.
Yeah, we're just doing an interview at the moment. Sorry, what was?
It might even help your interview, show your generosity.
Yeah.
I'm almost now, I've got me on safe, don't worry.
Take
care, alright?
That's alright.
See
you again.
Take care, man.
Alright, so what were we saying?
In London and America, there's just a lot more opportunity to create with other people and, you know, find people that you genuinely can vibe with, and there's a lot more opportunity for battling, opportunities for performances, things like that, where you can really start making a name for yourself and actually start making money, because ultimately, if you want to get far in this industry, you need to start making money from dance. So that's really my tips for you guys.
What are the positives about dance in Bristol for you?
The positives is that Bristol is just a really awesome place to make videos. I actually have a YouTube channel. My name is Official Mixed Vibes, so make sure you check out that channel because it's got I just made a video and with my boy Visuals right here, and it's absolutely fire. Like, I really cannot wait for you guys to see it. There's not much dance scenes going on, like battles and
it's quite small,
performances,
isn't it?
Like that. Yeah. You probably got a few workshops, so if you're into your choreography, I'm sure you can find some places for choreography, things like that. So don't worry about that if you're a choreographer. But for people who do freestyle, you know, freestyle is the future and all of that, then yeah, I would recommend London or places like that, which is where I'm aiming to go in the future.
Are there any final thoughts you wanted to add to this?
Well, dance is a beautiful thing, right? Because me and Visuals, we met through what we do. So it's, and like, we're good friends now, aren't it? So if you think about it, what, like, being a creative artist, what that can bring to you, so many cool things, you know. You meet so many new people. I made so many new friends from dancing, and yeah, it's just a great way to network. And because we met in a park, it was just cool, you know. I met him through a rapper, and
yeah,
it's like everyone just collabs. We're all here for each other, you know.
Very local.
It's all a community. So, this is a wrap.
Yeah, it's started raining. So, but conveniently, the interview, well, that's all the questions done. So, yeah, thank you very much, David. And we're going to go inside.
Peace.
As it turned out, we didn't go inside, and instead we actually met up with another dancer called Nima. Nima came to help David train for a dance battle he was preparing for, so I took this as an opportunity to film this on-the-spot dance video then both. This lasted till about 8 p.m, which meant we'd been filming videos about 8 hours that day, and since then we've both gained great success from our videos, in particular this one where we tried out a new filming technique involving circling the dancer. A lot of people liked that video, and it's now on 4,000 plus views, which really shows the progress we've made. My next interview was with Anshel, the owner of Bollyred, a Bristol-based Bollywood dance company. Anshel first got in touch with me early April 2019, asking about us working together on dance videos for her YouTube channel. I was excited by this, as I'd never been asked to film by an established company before, and was looking forward to trying out a completely different style of dance.
Hello and welcome to this segment of the documentary. I'm here with Anshel.
Hey, hello.
And if you'd just like to introduce yourself.
Yes. So, hi everyone, I'm Anshel Gupta. I am dancer by profession, currently based in Bristol, but originally I am from Mumbai, India. And I have a very small Bollywood dance company in Bristol called as Bollyred.
Cool. So, your style of dance, that's... What would you say it is?
Yeah, so I specialize in a couple of styles. To begin with, I'm an Indian classically trained dancer, that is Bharatanatyam. So I'm trained in that style for 13 years. I have a degree in Bharatanatyam. I have been dancing Bollywood since very young. I'm from 2012, I started training in salsa and bachata. I went to California to professionally train in those styles. These are the four styles I kind of dance with and choreograph with. That's Bharatanatyam, Bollywood, salsa and bachata.
So you would say, it's been quite easy, or to like...
No, it hasn't. It was not easy at all. So I started in April 2016, and for the first 6 months, I only had 5 students. The same 5 students. It was crazy, but I think I never judge my success based on the number of students I have. Currently, I have 5 different branches, 2 in London, 3 in Bristol. I have a dance team. We perform all over UK. We have traveled to Germany. We have traveled to Belfast. So after 3 years, it's amazing. But if I would have stopped, like when I started, like, yeah, in 3 months time, and I had same 5 people, I would have never been able to reach this far. So yeah, so it's just about like keep doing what you love to do and things will start rolling.
Yeah. It's all about that consistency.
Yeah, consistency, definitely. Yeah.
What's your opinion on the Bristol dance scene as a whole then, since you've moved there?
Yeah, so I am from Mumbai, and Mumbai is very big and culturally, it's very diverse, and the dancing scene was massive. So when I moved to Bristol, when you move to any new place, it's really difficult to understand what the place is like. So it took me a little while to figure out about Bristol, but then slowly things started unfolding, and I realized that Bristol has a lot to offer dance-wise. And I think in every artistic section, it has very diverse people trying to do different things, and every individual has a different idea, and it is welcomed in Bristol. So people don't shut the ideas out, but they are welcomed to explore. I think when I started, I couldn't see a lot of dance scene, but last 3 years, the dance scene has massively grown. There are amazing teachers doing many different styles. The African style is quite big in Bristol. The contemporary has gone big. There are fantastic hip-hop teachers, and there's Asian dancing, there's Indian dancing. So I think it's quite diverse in Bristol now, and it has opportunities, various platforms where the dancers can go and present their style, what they're bringing to Bristol. So I think Bristol is quite welcoming for all the artists. So I love that about Bristol, but it's growing.
Yeah,
it's just growing and growing, and people are getting more and more chances to express themselves. So it's good, and it's getting better.
So finally, I was just wondering if you had any thoughts you wanted to add to this.
I would like to say this, that Bristol has a lot to offer dancing wise, and if you have ever thought that you want to try a dance style but you're not sure about what's for you, I would say don't hesitate to start from any point, because unless and until you give it a try, you will never know if it's for you or not. And don't hesitate to reach out to any teacher, because they are there to provide a service to you. So and every teacher has got good social media presence nowadays. So if you can just go and have a look on their Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, you will know what kind of style that is, and you will get to see it. And then if you like it even a tiny bit, I would say just go out there, talk to the teacher, give it a try, and if you love it, then you can continue it.
Well, that's some really good advice. So thank you, Anshul.
Thank you so much, Luke. And if you watch our videos, he's the man behind the camera. So, and it's fun. It's amazing to have him in front of the camera and talking to him.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we are always troubling him with all our mistakes and all our retakes. So I hope you enjoy doing this.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think this will be really good for just dance in general and learning.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it is. Learning in general.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Thank you for making this documentary, because it's really important to have such talks so that people get to know more about this.
Yeah.
And I'm happy that you're doing this. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Talking to Anshul, I could see that she is very knowledgeable and passionate about dance, whether it's classical, Bollywood, salsa, or just dance in general. I also got the impression that she's not only been able to adapt very well into the Bristol dance scene, but also added to it immensely with her dance classes and character, along with the rest of Bollyred. My third and final interview was with Simon, the owner of Streetenvy, in my opinion and many others, the biggest dance academy in Bristol. Simon first got into contact with me around mid-June 2019 after hearing about me from the Bollyred videos. The first video we then filmed was Streetenvy at Bristol Pride, which was an amazing experience, especially being able to go backstage at the O2 Academy. Since then, the videos have ranged from weekday classes, big events, and even a dancing through time video, so I'm always looking
looking forward to seeing what the next project is with Streetenvy.
Hello, and I'm here at Streetenvy. I'm with Simon, who runs it. If you'd like to just tell the people what Streetenvy is all about and yourself.
Thank you very much. Hey, I'm Simon. So here at Streetenvy, we've got children's classes from ages 3 to teenagers. Then we have adult classes. We've got beginners, intermediate and advanced levels with performance teams and competition groups. We've got street dance, commercial, musical theatre, contemporary ballet, cabaret, and breakdance. We've got several other styles going on. We have workshops. We have professionals come on in. So we've got it all going on here.
So how long has Streetenvy been going?
Streetenvy has been going now for 10 years. We started in Oxford, moved to Bristol nearly 9 years ago now. So the studio that we're in, this has been here for 9 years. We set up in Bristol back in 2011, nearly 12. It's going strong. It's going good. Yeah.
How hard has it been to establish a dance company in Bristol, and like, what are the type of ways you've done that?
There have been several hurdles, but I guess persistence and passion, they play a big part. The type of ways I've done this are to just continue doing what I do, to enjoy what I do, and to pass that on to other people as well. And we're renowned for having a friendly community here. So I think that's the way I've gone about it. And I feel that that's how I've got over those hurdles, and we've built up from pretty much nothing in Bristol. So
personally, I don't know much about dance, but it seems to me that this dance studio is like one of the biggest ones in Bristol. Is that?
People keep telling us that. I feel like, going back to the last question with persistence and passion, I feel like there aren't that many centres as such. You've got a lot of teachers teaching various styles, but there aren't exactly that many dance-focused centres. So people tend to hire gyms or just studios on the side of gyms. So I guess we are. We have two shows a year, and we perform at a lot of events. We've got competitions going on. So I feel that people come here, and we're quite well known in Bristol now for being one of the biggest dance studios.
So what's your opinion of the Bristol dance scene as a whole, and how does it differ from like the other places you've danced in?
Okay, so I've lived in a couple of places in the UK, and especially the closer you are to London, the attitude tends to be that if you want to go down the professional side of things, you need to move to London, or you need to be willing to commute in London. I do feel that here we do offer opportunities with professionals such as Michael Jackson's choreographer, a lady from the Greatest Showman cast coming in. So there are opportunities here, but I do feel that it's something that is frowned upon as for professional dancers to train in Bristol, and they're required to move to bigger cities or capital cities. Yeah,
I see. Yeah. So it's pretty good for like starting off, would you say?
I think there are plenty of opportunities here, definitely for starting off, especially from an early age, whether it be singing, acting or dancing. I think there is a lot going on in Bristol. And for beginner adults, or also people that want to just do dance as a hobby, they enjoy it as a passion, they don't want to make a career out of it, I think it's great. Having said that, there are a few agencies that will promote in the area, and that will take dancers on. So there are opportunities. If you're willing to look for it, then the work is there.
Yeah. That's good to know. Finally, I was just wondering if you had any thoughts to add to this.
I do feel that, I just remember the first time I went to a dance class, I wouldn't go on my own. I was quite nervous. I thought it would be daunting, everyone would be professional, it would be a case that I was the worst in the class. That's not the case. If you just find the right style, the right level for you, I feel that you're welcomed. All of our instructors here, they're very welcoming. All of our students are very welcoming. So it doesn't matter which class you go to, you'll have a great time. But of course, look on our website and make sure you know which one has the right level for your experience in dance. One other thing I would say in Bristol, I feel that there is a great variety of styles out there, whether it be Bollywood, belly dance, pole dance, street dance, commercial. There are so many opportunities for you. Living in other cities across the UK, I think we are blessed here, because we've got such a variety of people with global experience. It's one of the best cities for dance in the UK, if you ask me, from a beginner, intermediate, hobby and professional point of view.
So yeah, if you wanted to dance here, learn to dance, if you enjoyed the rest of the documentary, feel like you need to get involved, then head up the website.
www.streetenvy.co.uk.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little plug there. And yeah, thanks for watching. Thank you, Simon.
No worries, thank you very much.
Put on your red shoes and dance.